How do you invest in today's deflationary environment without losing sight of inflation to come? Well, our first guest is John Brynjolfsson. He is a pioneer in real return funds that are designed to deliver inflation-beating returns by investing in alternative assets like commodities and inflation-linked bonds. And John spent many years at PIMCO, where his real return platform grew to $80 billion in assets. He recently started his own investment management firm, Armored Wolf, that will focus on alternative real assets and emerging markets. And our next guest is a legendary value investor, market historian, and a familiar face on WealthTrack. He is David Dreman. He is founder, chairman, and chief investment officer of Dreman Value Management, and his flagship DWS Dreman High Return Equity Fund has had a tough year along with most value funds, but long term, he still has a market-beating performance. And our third guest is new to WealthTrack. She is Christine Fahlund. She is a senior financial planner and vice president of mutual fund firm T. Rowe Price. Christine has more than 25 years' experience in financial planning and specializes in retirement strategies. So welcome to all of you. It's great to have you here. Mm-hmm. So this is quite a quandary, is that, you know, we're in a deflationary environment in many asset classes, but we know down the road we're going to be dealing with inflation. So, John, going through this period now of asset deflation, whether it be stocks, bonds, or commodities, whatever, how long do you think that this period is going to last?
Well, we're in a tough economic environment. We've got financial meltdown that was originally precipitated by a little bit of an economic slowdown, but now we have a financial meltdown that's going to cause an additional second leg in the economic slowdown, and that can last some while, you know, 6-12 months of economic slowdown and downward pressure on prices.
On prices. Okay. David, what do you think? You're a market historian, so, you know, what's your perspective on what we're in for as far as, again, this contraction in credit that John just mentioned and also this deflation in prices and a lot of different asset prices? Yes.
Well, I think we're probably seeing the worst crisis and financial crisis since the 1930s, maybe even before that, because I'm not sure it was that hard to get a loan if you had resources in the 30s. I think this is going to take a while to unwind. The Fed is putting money in, and as is the Treasury in many ways, but it seems to me they've, over this last 18 months, they've been slow to recognize just how deep the problem was, and they've tended to be reactive and not proactive. They've tended to do too little too late. And even the latest plan that we went through Congress, and $700 billion, that's been changed again. And so 250 is going to the banks, and yet the banks, his question was, John said, may not use the money. They're kind of shell-shocked.
Right. They're hoarding it. I mean, in many respects, they're not lending.
And so interest rates aren't going down.
Yeah. So the answer is we could be in this kind of contractionary period for a while.
I would think so. Again, it could be a 12-month period, maybe somewhat longer.
Yeah. So, now, Christine, I know that this is not your bailiwick, but you are a financial planner. You specialize in retirement services. So in this particular climate with, again, asset prices that most of us have invested in falling, mm-hmm. You know, what are you telling retirees how they can protect their nest egg?
They need to hold on, stay the course. It's hard to say that because they've heard it before. It's not something new. But it is absolutely what they need to do. They have to focus on the 20 or 30 years that they're going to be in retirement. That's what they can do. They need to focus on what they can control as opposed to what they can't.
All right, they clearly cannot control the market
or
the economy.
They can't control the markets. They can control how much they're withdrawing from their investments. And when we do the modeling and the computer simulations, what do we find? We find over and over and over again, it's the amount you're withdrawing. If you're withdrawing too much, it's likely your money will not last through 20 to 30 years. So cut back if you can. If you can't cut back, at least don't be increasing your withdrawals over the next few years. Try to live on a fixed income from your investments.
At least. Really a fixed income and not have the
COLA. Do not increase for inflation.
Yeah. So you know, John, as a real return manager, you know, and you're focusing on protecting purchasing power, not an easy thing to do when a lot of asset classes are declining. And against the ravages of inflation, which is what we normally live with, is inflation, not what we're going through right now. So how do you deal with asset deflation as a real return manager?
Well, in an ideal world, you could be both long or short. And in this kind of environment, there have been a lot of opportunities on the short side. But the other approach is to be in solid assets, things like, you know, we look at things like the Swiss franc, gold, other assets that hold their value during crises have been doing well in this environment. In a deflationary environment, you know, the most prices of things are going down, and that makes it very difficult as an investor. You want to also stay away from risk assets. Equities, high yield bonds have obviously been getting crushed in this environment.